more at home tribal, any chance?
No, not available. So he got some injections for his back, and for tomorrow, not available. Probably also not for the weekend game for Sheffield. Yeah, a bit sad for us, but it is like it is, and we have to handle it.
So literally, it is just sort of rest and sort of manage it. Hopefully, the problem will clear and it'll be okay for maybe a week after next.
Yeah, hopefully. So we try after this injections, I think 2 or 3 days in this week, he has to get this. If everything works in the middle of next week, that's a plan. He's able to be back in training. So that would mean, okay, for the Brentford game or the next round in the FA Cup, he would be available, but not for tomorrow, not for the for the weekend game. If it doesn't work with the injections, yeah, then we have to wait a bit how long we have to do without him. So, yeah, to be honest, in the moment we are a bit concerned, but it is like it is. So sometimes there are some injuries, and hopefully he can return pretty soon.
Marley Watkins, obviously, you said he had a slight issue with his knee, couldn't play at Bristol. How's he looking for tomorrow?
At least he's available, so he returned back to team training, and he's available with us.
And in terms of Chelsea, is it? I know you talked about them in terms of Giants and what a great result it was at Carrow Road, but you know, they're 4 games without a win now, not scoring a lot of goals. Is this potentially a good time to go and play them, do you think?
I'm not sure, to be honest. I would prefer if they are there with 4 wins and perhaps not so focused and don't pay so much attention on this game, because it means like, yeah, there's a bit pressure on them, because I think in the last 4 games they were just 4 draws, and I think in the last 3 games they were not able to score. So for that, I think they will be pretty greedy to show that they are able to score, especially in the home game, and they're able to go into the next round. And also they are a bit worn because of our really brilliant performance in the first game, and they know they have to be focused and really concentrated to beat us. And for that, I think it's even more tricky to be successful, especially because it's an away game. But it's like it is, so we can't change. So I would prefer to play at Carrow Road. I would prefer to play perhaps in a different moment against Chelsea, when they're not so focused on this game, when they have perhaps a big chance to win the title in the league as well. Because I think, yeah, the league title will normally go to Man City, and for that, Chelsea has to focus a bit more on the FA Cup to win a title. And for that, yeah, it's probably one of the most difficult tasks you can get, but it's like it is, and we can play this game without any pressure. We can enjoy this game, and yeah, to be honest, the most enjoyable game is when you're there with a good performance and hopefully with a really, really good result. And we're going there without any pressure, and we're looking forward to have this game, and we'll see what happens.
Do you think because of the run they're on, as you say, maybe the priority, they're going to have to play some of the cups, Conte might go a bit stronger tomorrow night, Hazard, Morata, these type of characters, do you think they might bring them in?
Yeah, it could be, but I don't see that they were there was a weak lineup against us. So when Pedro and Willian when you have to face on the defense Pedro and Willian, so I don't think there's a big difference. And even in the last role they played in the first game was I think Kay, Rüdiger and David Lewis, so it's not too bad. And Zappa Costa on the wing and all this lads. So yeah, I think they will be there with a really good squad. For sure they have to take care a bit of load, so like we have. So sometimes you bring some fresh players in who didn't play in the last game, but it is like it is, and I expect them to be there with a really good strong squad, really focused to be successful, because I think the FA Cup is a competition they have to pay a lot of attention in this year, and for that we're prepared to face the strongest opponent we can get.
Final one from me, you talk about the load. How much, in terms of your selection tomorrow night, will you have one eye on Sheffield United at the weekend?
Yeah, I think as a coach you always have to keep in mind, okay, what happens in the next games and the next week. I think the situation is perhaps not similar to the situation we had in the Cup when we played at the Emirates, because in this part of the season there were 4 or 5 games in a row, weeks in a row with 3 games per week, and it's not like over the Christmas period you have five games in 14 days, and sometimes you have to rest a player. This is right now, we had a really calm down and normal week before Bristol, and we will have it even in the next week before Brentford. So it's just 1 week with three games, and I think when you're in a good shape, it's not a problem to have one of this week. So it's more the problem when you have the fourth and the fifth and the sixth game within 14 days. So I think it's not the moment when you have to pay too much attention on this load, but we will watch pretty carefully in personal terms. For example, Mario Frančić was pretty sick in the last days, so he's available for tomorrow. But yesterday he was just in bed, and because he felt really sick after the last game in Bristol. Alex Tete, to be honest, is pretty tired, and you have to take care for him. So what we do with him, and also Grant Henley has some problems with his calf. So I don't think all three will be in the starting lineup tomorrow. We have to pay a bit attention how they feel tomorrow and have a short term decision. So there will be probably one or two changes, but I won't change the whole squad or something like this. So it's we want to be successful against Sheffield United 100%, because it's another important game in the league. Yeah, but we want to be successful as possible tomorrow too, and for that we will try to bring a really good and strong squad on the field.